This video demonstrates how to perform a line calculation for a given composition in a temperature range. As an example, we choose an aluminum-magnesium binary alloy with 30 atomic percent of magnesium from 700 degrees C to room temperature. To start a calculation, we first need to create a workspace by clicking the Create Workspace icon and selecting the PanPhaseDiagram module. Then click the T icon to load a thermodynamic database. Select the TDB file. Select components aluminum and magnesium. After the thermodynamic database is successfully loaded, you can see that all the functions in PanPhaseDiagram module are highlighted, which means they are activated and ready to be used for different types of calculations. We click the line icon for the line calculations. In this line calculation condition setting window, we need to set up the alloy composition and temperature for both start point and end point of the line. In the start point column, set temperature as 700 Celsius, 70% of aluminum, and right-click on the magnesium field. Set the composition of magnesium as balanced 30%. After setting the conditions of the start point, click the right arrow and copy all information from the start point to the end point. Then change the temperature to 25 degrees C. In this way, we do not need to type in the composition again, which is especially useful when multi-components are involved in the calculation. Before you click the OK to start calculation, please make sure the units are what you expected. You can change the units by clicking the Option button. In this example, we don't need to change units. Click OK to start the calculation. This is the default plot for a line calculation with fixed alloy composition. The x-axis is the temperature, and the y-axis is the fraction of phases. We can add legend on the graph to show the phases present in this temperature range. Click this legend button on the toolbar. Then click on the graph. The legend will be added. It shows the blue line represents the aluminum-magnesium beta phase. The red line represents the FCC phase and the green line the liquid phase. Here you can also change the scale of the diagram from the property window. For example, change the axis X minimum value to 200 degrees C. And change the Y axis to log scale. Log scale is particularly useful when the amounts of some phases are very small. The data behind this diagram are stored in the tables. Double-click the default table to open it. Here are the temperature, phase fractions and some other results, such as Gibbs energy of different phases. If you want to get some other results, which are not shown in the default table, for example, the phase composition, then you can edit this default table or add a new table to obtain the data from the calculated results. Put the mouse on the root node of the table. Right-click. Then select Add a New Table. In this table editor, you can drag and drop the properties to add it into the table. We need temperature. Drag and drop to the right column. And phase composition. When you click this property, there is a description below showing the meaning of this property. Here X star at star represents all the elements in phases. The first star represents elements, and the second star represents phases. In Pandat, you can also do some simple math function. Double-click in this field, then press Ctrl key and the M key. It will show a list of math functions. For example, we choose log t. Then click OK. In this added table, it contains the temperature, the composition of every stable phase, and also the log t. To plot the composition versus log t, first select log t column as x-axis. Then hold the Ctrl key and select other composition columns as y-axis. Then click this icon to create a new graph. Now you can see the graph with log t as the x-axis and composition as the y-axis. Add a legend showing the meaning of the curves. From this video, you learn how to do a line calculation with fixed composition and a temperature range, and how to create a new table with properties of interest. That's all for this video. If you want to learn more about Pandat software, please visit our website or our YouTube channel.